Okay. Laws of exponents. Okay. These are sometimes called as laws of indices also. Indices. Okay. Index is the power or exponent, right? The index is the singular word. Indices is the plural word, right? So the first law is called as product law. Okay. What do you mean by this is that, let's say if you have a base which is raised to, let's say, some exponent m, and you multiply with the same base a, but it is raised to some other another power n, for example, then if the bases are same and if they are multiplied, then you can combine the base. You can write base as a, okay, common base, and if this is multiplication, if there is multiplication, then the indices add up. Index काय होतात? Add होतात. So तुम्हाला काय मिळेल? A raised to m plus n मिळेल. Okay, I'll give you one example. एक दोन example देतो म्हणजे कळेल तुम्हाला. Let's say we have 7 raised to 2 multiplied by 7 raised to 3, right? So make sure that the base is same. पहिली गोष्ट लक्षात ठेवायची की base same आहे. Okay, base has to be same. Otherwise, you cannot use it, huh? And then if the base is same, you come write it only once. That means you combine it, and then you can, if there is multiplication, then you can add it to get 2 plus 3, so you get 7 raised to 5 as the answer. Let me give you one more example. Let's say you have 2 upon 3 raised to 4 into 2 upon 3 raised to let's say 5. Okay. So as you can see, 2 upon 3 is the base here, right? Which is same in both the cases. So you can say 2 upon 3, and if there is multiplication, then the indices add up. Index kya hota? Add hota. So you get 4 plus 5. So ultimately the answer will be 2 upon 3 raised to 9. That's all. Samajhle sagana? Is that clear, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Nakki? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so right now write down this one, give the heading laws of exponents slash laws of indices. Okay, write this down, then write down first law, product law. How do you remember? A raised to m into a raised to n is equal to a raised to m plus n. Okay, when the numbers are in the exponent form with the same base, make sure the bases are same. To get their product multiplication, add their powers or indices or exponents, keeping the base same. Base same as ठेवायचं, base नाही बदलायचं. Base add वगैरे काही करत बसायचं नाही. Index फक्त add करायचा. Okay? And इथे example दिलेले आहेत तुम्हाला. So these are the examples, right? I'll tell you about this one. मी हे separately सांगतो तुम्हाला. So right now, इथून ते एवढं इथपर्यंत लिहून टाका. हे नाही लिहिलं तरी चालेल. इज दॅट क्लिअर ना? सगळ्यांना समजलं इथपर्यंत?
येस सर.
आय विल एक्सप्लेन व्हॉट दीज टू एक्झाम्पल्स मीन. ओके, सो प्लीज पे अटेन्शन. व्हॉट अबाउट दिस? हिअर एज यू कॅन सी देर आर टू डिफरंट बेसेस, राईट? सो एक्स स्क्वेअर वाय क्यूब multiplied by x raised to 4 y square. This is one single term. Okay, you know about terms now, right? Terms are only separated by plus or minus sign. They are never separated by multiplication or division. So here what happens is you can take x square and x raised to 4 together. Everything is multiplication, no doubt about it. And x square and x raised to 4 tumhi ekatra ghyaycha, and x y cube and y square tumhi ekatra ghyaycha, combine them. So now what, why did we do this? Because we have to have same base. That's why we did it. Okay. You cannot add this. You cannot say x raised to x, y raised to 2 plus 3. No, 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 no. This cannot happen. This cannot happen. Why this cannot happen? Because x is a different base. Y is a different base. They do not match. Base has to be same to use this product tool, right? So what do? We make a combination of similar bases. So x raised x square into x raised to 4 into y cube into y square. So now you can use the product rule. So you can add the indices. So you get x raised to 2 plus 4 multiplied by y raised to 3 plus 2. So you get x raised to 6 y raised to 5. Okay, similarly here also, right? So here, first of all, what you have to do is here 4, 8, 3, these are called coefficients. What are they called? Coefficients. These are constants, right? These are numbers. So they don't have any power or anything like that. These are a constant numbers, simple numbers. So again, what you have to do is you have to initially multiply all the constants. So 4 multiplied by 8 multiplied by 3. Okay, again, don't worry, everything is multiplication. There is no addition or subtraction like that. This is one single term. So what you have to do, you have to, you have to combine. So in such a way that you can simplify. So 4 into 8 into 3, you combine all the constants, then you combine the powers of A. Okay, so A square, A raised to 9. Now, sometimes there is a confusion. Sir, what will happen to A only? What is A? A is nothing but A raised to 1. Okay, again, I will repeat this. Jiska koi nahi hota, uska 1 hota hai. Kya mantla mi? Jiska koi nahi hota, uska 1 hota hai. So, jiska koi index nahi hai, uska index 1 hota hai. Always remember, if I write X, X is nothing but X raised to 1. If I write Z, Z is nothing but Z raised to 1. Okay, jiska koi denominator nahi hota, uska 1 hota hai. So, remember always in mathematics, jiska koi nahi, uska 1. Remember. So here, A direct kelele, they have directly written this step, but that's okay now. You must have understood. So 2 plus 9 plus 1, right? Now B multiplied by B. B raised to 3 plus 6 plus 10. 3 plus 6 plus 10. And finally, C raised to 2 plus 1 plus 5, right? So what will be the addition here? Multiplication, 4 8s are 32, 32 3s are 96, and A raised to 2 plus 9 plus 1 is 12, B raised to 3 plus 6 plus 10 is 19, and C raised to 2 plus 1 plus 5 is 8. So final answer is going to be 96, A raised to 12, B raised to 19, C raised to 8. Is that clear? Samajh lo sagana?
Yes, sir.
Very. Let me give you one example and try to do it. Fourth one. Let's say we have 3x square y cube multiplied by 4xy raised to 4 multiplied by 5x cube y raised to 7. Bola, what will be the first step? What will you do?
Sir, 3 into 4 into 5 multiplied by x raised to 2 plus 1 plus 3. Multiplied by y raised to 3 plus 4 plus 7.
Very good. Yes. So first of all, you will combine all the constants. Everything is multiplication. Now you will combine the bases, which are x, and you will add the indices because of product rule, right? If there is multiplication of the bases, you add the index. Simple. So again, jiska koi nahi hota, yahan pe 1 hota, right? So you will get, you'll take x raised to 2 plus 1 plus 3 and then y raised to 3 plus 4 plus 7. So what will be the answer? 3 4s are 12, 12 5s are 60. 60 x raised to 6, y raised to 14. Is that clear? Got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now the second law, which is also known as quotient law. Okay, product means multiplication, right? Multiplication of numbers. Quotient means division. Okay, exactly opposite of multiplication. So division and multiplication are opposite of each other, correct? So what happens in quotient law is, if a number having some base raised to some power divided by the same base raised to some another power, right? Then you subtract the indices. You subtract the exponent. Multiplication madhe add karayacha, division madhe subtract karayacha. Simple. Kai avgad nahi hai, right? Ata, in the textbook, they have mentioned two different things. Okay, I'll explain it with the example. Actually, nahi kela hai tari chalnar hai. Let me explain that also. So A raised to M, right, is the numerator divided by a raised to n, which is the denominator. So if it is division, make sure that the bases are same. Ahe ka? Ahe. So you have a raised to m upon a raised to n is equal to a raised to m minus n. You have to subtract the indices. When is it then? When the index of the numerator is greater than the index of the denominator. When the index of the numerator is greater than the index of the denominator, then it can be done. Okay. Suppose in some case the index of the denominator is greater than the index of the numerator. Then what you do? You simply bring this to the denominator. So instead of taking it to the numerator, you bring the numerator to the denominator. जे आपण minus numerator ला करत होतो ते फक्त denominator ला करायचं. Okay? And instead of m minus n, you do n minus m. Why here? Because n is greater than m. As I said, the index of the denominator is greater than the index of the numerator. म्हणून करायचं. बाकी काही नाही. Right? So when a number in exponent form is divided by another number in the exponent form, both the numbers having the same base, the smaller index is subtracted from the bigger index and the base is kept the same. Okay, आता आपण दोन्हीचे example बघूया. For example, x raised to 5 divided by x raised to 3. Whose index is greater, numerator or denominator? Numerator, right? So smaller is subtracted from the larger. So you have to subtract the index of the denominator from the numerator. So you'll have x raised to 5 upon x raised to 3, right? Another form of writing the quotient. And you will subtract 3 from 5. So 5 minus 3 gives you x square, x raised to 2. But here something else is there. You have 15a square divided by 5a raised to 10. You can get rid of 5. You can take the common factor. 5 ones are, 5 threes are. That is not a problem. You can do anything with the numbers as usual, as we were doing in the fractions. But here, the index of the denominator is larger than the index of the numerator, right? So what you will do, you will subtract the smaller index from the larger, right? So you will subtract 2 from 10, not 10 from 2. So you'll have 3 upon a raised to 10 minus 2. So you'll get 3 upon a raised to 8. Is this clear, everyone? Samajhla hai?
Yes, sir.
Nakki? Okay, sir. All right. So please write this down. Heading there, second law, quotient law. Write this down. Don't write the statement, and write down these two examples. We have to see many examples afterwards. But at least now, for now, you can write down these two examples. Okay. Just let me know when you are done. Okay. The third law, which is also called as power law or power rule, is that suppose a base is raised to some exponent and that total in totality is raised to some another exponent, right? So for example, a is the base, which is raised to some exponent m, which is raised to some another exponent n. Then what do we get is we get multiplication of the exponents. So how to read it? A raised to m raised to n is equal to a raised to m into n. Okay, I'll give you example. So for instance, a square raised to cube, a raised to 2 raised to 3, okay, is equal to a raised to 2 into 3. Mulanna kay confusion hota, they take a raised to 2 raised to 3 and they think, are 2 raised to 3 means 2 cha cube means a raised to 8. Wrong. No, it's not like that. This is not cube of 2. No. Okay. That's why we have brackets. Right. You cannot have power of a power of a power. No, it's not possible. Right. So here you have to make sure that you multiply the exponents. That's all. You don't have to exponent the exponent. Right. So what will be the answer? A raised to 2 raised to 3 is a raised to 2 into 3. That is a raised to 6. Samajhle? Itparyanta?
Yes, sir.
Right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Let's take this example. X raised to 6 raised to 3 upon 2. So it is simple. X raised to 6 into 3 upon 2. So 2 ones are, 2 threes are. Now you will multiply 3 into 3. So you get x raised to 9 as the answer. Nakki, 100% kalla. Very good. Okay. So write this down, third law. So when a number in the index form is raised to another index, the base is raised to the product of the two indices. And write down these two examples. Write down everything. And then we'll start with some more laws of indices, so to speak. Okay, some more examples. So now there are a few things you should know. These are not exactly the laws, but these are a few, you can say, simplification techniques which we use usually in solving problems, right? For example, here, AB raised to M, what is the difference between the first law and this law is that here the bases are not same, but the index is same, right? So initially what we had A raised to M into A raised to N. Bases were same, so we used to add the index. Here what happens is A raised to M into B raised to M. So bases are not same, but index is same. So what you can do, you can combine the bases and then you can make it raised to M. Okay, likewise. So this is what happens, right? Asa karayach. For example, I'll give you 5 raised to 4 into 3 raised to 4, right? Bases are not same, but index are same. Indices are same. So you can say 5 multiplied by 3 bracket raised to 4. So 5 threes are kiti honar? 15 raised to 4. This is the answer. Okay, this is how you have to do it. Few more examples. XY whole cube is X cube into Y cube. 2A cube whole square is 2 square. So 2 chapan square karaycha. And A raised to 3 raised to 2 pan karaycha. Here you have to use power rule now. Right? Power law. So 2 square is 4. And A raised to 3 raised to 2 is A raised to 3 into 2. That is 6. Okay? Asa karaycha. The another way is same thing is applicable for division also. So A upon B raised to M, you can separate the indices A raised to M upon B raised to M. Simple. So you get 3, for example, 3x upon 4y square whole raised to 4 is 3 raised to 4 into x raised to 4 upon 4 raised to 4 into y square raised to 4. So 3 raised to 4 is 81. X raised to 4 divided by 4 raised to 4 is 256 and y raised to 2 raised to 4 is y raised to 2 into 4. That is y raised to 8. Okay. This is how you have to do it. Don't write anything. Let me explain the other two also. Now, this is important. So any number raised to any non-zero number raised to zero is always one. For example, minus 5 raised to 0, 1. 5 raised to 0, 1. 81,000 raised to 0, 1. Minus 51,000 215 raised to 0, 1. Whatever it may be, it has to be 1. But any non-zero number, the reason is that 0 raised to 0 is not 1. It is not defined. Okay, you cannot define it. Okay, it is not possible. 0 raised to 0 like value nahi hai. Okay, there is a debate going on. In the scientific and mathematical community that whether it is one or not, but right now it has been decided that 0 raised to 0 is not defined. Okay, it is not equal to 1. Is that clear? Samajle tumhala iparanta, right? Okay, there is a catch. 1 minute. Let's say I have minus 3 raised to 0. What is the answer? 1. But now tell me the answer. Minus 3 raised to 0 without the bracket. What will be the answer? Tell me. Yes.
1.
नाही मायनस वन याचा आंसर आहे. का सांगतो इकडे बघा, व्हॉट इज द डिफरन्स? व्हिज्युअली देर इज अ डिफरन्स दॅट इन द फर्स्ट केस वी हॅव ब्रॅकेट्स, सो मायनस थ्री द एंटायर नंबर वॉज रेस टू झिरो. मायनस थ्री इज अ नॉन झिरो नंबर. वेन आय से नॉन झिरो इट कॅन बी नेगेटिव्ह, इट कॅन बी पॉझिटिव्ह, फक्त तो झिरो नसायला पाहिजे. सो नॉन झिरो मीन्स एनिथिंग अदर दॅन झिरो, एनिथिंग एनिथिंग एनी एनी नंबर, एनी रियल नंबर. म्हणजे मायनस रूट टू पण असू शकतो, एनिथिंग, मायनस सेवन अपॉइंट फाईव्ह पण असू शकतो, व्हॉट एव्हर इट मे बी. सो दिस इज वन. वाय? बिकॉज आय हॅव गिव्हन ब्रॅकेट्स, सो दॅट एंटायर नंबर इज रेस टू झिरो, सो इट इज वन. बट इन द सेकंड केस आय हॅव नॉट गिव्हन ब्रॅकेट्स हिअर, सो ब्रॅकेट इज ओनली फॉर थ्री, नॉट फॉर द नेगेटिव्ह साईन. सो इफ यू गिव्ह ब्रॅकेट्स हिअर, थ्री रेस टू झिरो, आय विल डू स्टेप बाय स्टेप, 3 raised to 0 is 1 and minus sign will be carried as it is, so answer will be minus 1, not 1. Are you following the difference between the two?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Okay, very good. Ithe mi example lihun thevto. So 5 raised to 0, 1. Minus 3 raised to 0 is 1, but minus 3 raised to 0 is minus 1. Okay, you can write both of these because this is very, very important. I have seen so many mistakes in this because the concepts are not clear. So make sure where is the bracket. If the bracket is for negative sign also, then yes, it is 0. But if the bracket is for the only for the number, then it is not 0. Okay, tell me what is the answer of this? Minus of minus 3 bracket raised to 0. What will be the answer?
1.
Sorry?
1.
No.
Minus 1.
Correct. Minus 1 is the answer. Minus 3 raised to 0 is 1. This minus sign is there. He could have given sign. He paije na. So minus 1 is the answer. Very good. Okay. समजलं का फरक कळतोय का तुम्हाला काय चाललंय ते? ओके, इट इज अ व्हेरी व्हेरी मायन्यूट थिंग, व्हेरी मायन्यूट. अँड आय सी रिमेंबर दोज हु वर कमिंग फ्रॉम सिक्स स्टँडर्ड, आय यूज टू टेल यू ब्रॅकेट्स आर युअर फ्रेंड्स. मी बोललो होतो की नाही तुम्हाला बऱ्याच वेळेला, का नाही बोललो, का नव्हतं सांगितलं? आता सांगतो, ब्रॅकेट्स आर युअर फ्रेंड्स. काय आहेत ब्रॅकेट्स? ब्रॅकेट्स किंवा पॅरेंथिसिस काय आहेत? आपले मित्र आहेत, दे आर आवर फ्रेंड्स, यूज देम. ओके, डोंट टेक द ऍडव्हान्टेज बट यूज देम, मेक शुअर यू अंडरस्टँड अँड यूज देम. ओके, दे आर गोइंग टू हेल्प अस अ लॉट. ओके, दे आर गोइंग टू सेव्ह अस फ्रॉम गेटिंग इनकरेक्ट आन्सर्स. ओके, ऑलवेज रिमेंबर ब्रॅकेट्स आर अवर फ्रेंड्स. Okay, second one, x square upon 2y raised to 0, anything raised to 0 is 1, so it doesn't matter, don't calculate, so you'll get answer 1. And the last is, suppose the index is negative. Okay, so if you want to make it positive, take the reciprocal and make it positive. I mean, change the sign. For example, a raised to minus n. So if you take the reciprocal, you know what is reciprocal, right? Numerator becomes the denominator, right? And denominator becomes the numerator. So a raised to minus m is 1 upon a raised to m, and 1 upon a raised to minus m is a raised to m, right? Same thing. So whenever you take the reciprocal, remember, whenever you take the reciprocal, the base remains the same, the sign of the index changes. Let me give you an example. Let's say 5 raised to minus 3 is nothing but 1 upon 5 raised to 3. So whenever you take the reciprocal, the base remains the same, the sign of the index changes. Index jar negative asel tar to positive hoto ani positive asel tar negative hoto, right? Let me give you one more example. 7 raised to 1 upon 2, so index is positive. Let's say I have to make it negative, so I'll say 1 upon 7 raised to minus 1 upon 2. That's the only thing. Base never changes. When you take the reciprocal, base never changes, the sign of the index changes. Index also doesn't change numerically, the sign changes. Plus asel tar minus, minus asel tar plus. Is this clear 100% everyone?
Oh sir.
Very good.
Yes sir.
Okay, so I mean, I think you're quite familiar with square root or cube root of something like that, right? So root manje kay? Tar basically, let's say I have a raised to n. So a is being multiplied n number of times, for example, right? Tar hecha exactly opposite. For let's say we have a raised to 1 upon n, okay? Then it is nothing but nth root of a. Asa lihta, okay? I'll give you one example, manje clear will tumhala. Let's say 2 raised to 3 is what? 2 into 2 into 2, that is 8. Okay, so if 2 raised to 3 is 8, then 8 raised to 1 upon 3 is 2. Okay, if you transfer the index to the other side, it will be a reciprocal of the index. So 8 raised to 1 upon 3 is nothing but cube root of 8, asa manta, cube root. Chota sa 3 lehcha, it is not multiplication. Ha radical sign manta, hecha aath lehcha, cube root of 8, asa lehcha. Okay, which is 2, asa. Okay, so square root of a is a raised to 1 upon 2. Square root of 3 is 3 raised to 1 upon 2. Reciprocal, index are reciprocal lehcha. Cube root of a is a raised to 1 upon 3. Cube root of 3 is a raised to 3 raised to 1 upon 3. Square root of a raised to 5. This is slightly different. Hecha artha kay hai ki a raised to 5 tar ahech hai pan square root hai. Square root manje into half honar ha index manje he yenar hai a raised to 5 upon 2. This is slightly at this level this is slightly difficult to understand, but don't worry, you will get used to it and we don't have much problems on this, but at least you must understand the concept of this, right? Now what you have to write down is you just write down this part, this one. Evadas lya fakta he number nakal star mark kara evada lya ani then after that write this one star mark kara. Okay, just write these two things, that's all.